President, the junior friend says that you wait till I get my elder brother. And his elder brother happens to be the biggest hooligan of that area. When the child is telling the senior student that you wait till I get my elder brother, he is not actually asking him to wait. He's telling him, you scoot off, you buzz off, otherwise you'll be taught a lesson. You don't do it. Similarly, when Allah says in the Holy Quran, فَتَرَبَّصُوا, it does not mean wait. It means you better wake up. فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهِ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Wait until Allah brings about His decision unto you. Until Allah brings about His destruction unto you. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. And Allah guides not the forward returns. Yes, sir. So Allah is asking the Muslims that you better improve, that you better wake up, otherwise destruction will come upon you. And Allah guides not the forward transgressor. Allah tells us in the Holy Quran, in Surah Muhammad, chapter number 47, verse number 38, He says, وَإِنْ تَتَوَلَّوْا يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَكُنْ أَمْثَالُكُمْ. That if you turn away from your path, if you do not do your job, يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ, Allah will substitute in your place another people, ثُمَّ لَا يَكُنْ أَمْثَالُكُمْ, and they will not be like you. So Allah is telling that if you do not do your job, if you turn away from the path, Allah will substitute in your place another people, ثُمَّ لَا يَكُنْ أَمْثَالُكُمْ, and they will not be like you. And history testifies this, that Allah has His way, that whenever He substitutes a people, He always chooses the people who are looked down upon. Those people who are looked down upon, Allah brings them from the dust and makes them to sit on our head. For example, if you see history, the Jews looked down upon the Arabs. They said, these Arabs, they are barbaric people. And when Allah says in the Holy Quran in Surah Jumu'ah chapter number 62, verse number 5, that the similitude of the Jews who were asked to deliver the Mosaic law, who were asked to deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they did not do the job, is same as a donkey who is carrying tons of book, but he understands it not. The Jews were asked to deliver the message, but they said, what is the use of delivering the message to these people, the Arabs? And at that time, it was the Yawmul Jahiliyyah. The Arabs, it was called the days of ignorance. No one even wanted to rule the Arabs. They were so ignorant that they did the tawaf around the Kaaba absolutely naked. They had a beautiful logic. They said that, how can we present ourselves better than the way we came in this world? Therefore they did the tawaf around the Kaaba absolutely naked. Even the conquerors, they did not want to rule them. They were not fit to be ruled. The Arabs, they were looked down upon. So Allah, through His Holy Quran, through His revelation, these ignorant people, He makes them the torchbearer. He makes them to sit on the heads of the Jews. Allah has His way. The Jews don't do the job. Allah says, يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ. Allah will substitute in your place another people, ثُمَّ لَا يَكُنْ أَمْثَالُكُمْ, and they will not be like you. But unfortunately, if you see the history, the Arabs, the Muslims, we ruled Spain for about 800 years. But we did not do the job. We did not do da'wah. Later on, the Crusaders came and we were wiped out. There was not even a single man who could openly give the azan, imagine. And today, the only thing we can see in Spain, besides the bullfighting and the castanets, is the beautiful buildings and the monuments made by our forefathers. But we did not do the job, so Allah substitute the people. Allah has His ways. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Holy Quran, He gives us guidance. We Muslims, we say that we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anyone else in the world. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than our mother. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than our father, our sister, our brother, our wife. We say, Alhamdulillah, we say. But do we actually mean it? Verbally we say, we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anyone in the world. But actually, do we mean it? I want to ask a question. Let's suppose your neighbor, if he abuses your wife, or if he abuses your sister, and if you come to know about it, what will you do? You will surely hammer your neighbor, or you put him in his place. If you yourself are not capable of treating your neighbor, unless then what will you do? You will hire somebody else to put him in his place, won't you? Of course. Why? Because we love our mother, we love our sister. If anyone abuses our sister, if the neighbor abuses our sister or mother, you see to it that you will put the neighbor in his place. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he cries in the Holy Quran. He says in Surah Maryam, chapter number 19, verse number 88-92, he says, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذُوا الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا. And they say, the Christians, they say, Allah most gracious has begotten a son. Allah is crying in the Holy Quran. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذُوا الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا لَقَدْ جِتُّ مَشَيًّا إِذَّا. It is indeed the most monstrous thing to say. To say that Allah has begotten a son, it is the most heinous abuse you can give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذُوا الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا لَقَدْ جِتُّ مَشَيًّا إِذَّا. تَقَادُ السَّمَوَاتِ فَتَّرْنَا مِنُّ. As though the skies are ready to burst open. وَتَلَشَكُ الْأَرْضُ. And the earth to split asunder. وَتَخِرُ الْجِبَارُ حَدَّا. And the mountains to fall down to utter ruin. Allah says that if you say Allah has begotten a son, it is as though the skies will burst open. The earth will split asunder. And the mountains will fall down to utter ruin. But to us Muslims, it makes no difference. It makes no difference at all. Our neighbors, our Christian neighbors, our non-Muslim neighbors, our friends, they many a times abuse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They keep on saying that Allah has begotten a son. But to us Muslims, it makes no difference at all. But we say verbally that we love Allah more than our sister, more than our mother. If it was the fact, when someone abuses our sister and our mother, we want to put the neighbor in his place. Why don't we want to do the same when someone abuses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why don't you deliver the message to him? Why don't you clarify the misconception that he has? Our Christian neighbor, our Christian friends, they say that Allah has begotten a son. And they quote, as we should keep on quoting the Bible, they say, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 3, verse number 16, that God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not die, but shall have everlasting life. Have we tried to deliver the message to them? Have we tried to correct them? Have we made an effort? Allah says, it's the biggest abuse you can give to him. And Allah says in the Holy Quran in Surah Baqarah chapter number 2, verse number 120, he says, وَلَنْ تَرْدَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَنْ نَسَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعُ مِلَّتِهِمْ. Which means that the Jews and the Christians will never be satisfied until you follow their brand of religion. They will never be satisfied. And Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Baqarah chapter number 2, verse number 111, وَقَالُوا, they say, the Jews and the Christians, وَقَالُوا, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. That you Muslims, you shall never enter Jannah until you become a Jew or a Christian. The Jews and the Christians, they say that you Muslims, with your salah, with the mark on your forehead, with your zakah, with your hajj, with your Ramadan, with your fasting, with all these things, still you shall never enter Jannah until you become a Jew or a Christian.